What have you there? Sharply questioned Mrs. Thompson. So the moment he entered into his house, he was asked question by Mrs. Thompson, but that why did you have? Joe felt the child start and shrink against him. The tone of Mrs. Thompson was very sharp. That is why the child was little bit frightened, and Joe felt the frightenedness of the child. He didn't reply, except by a look that was pleading and cautionary. Pleading and cautionary means ignoring. He knew that his wife might behave rudely, so he didn't reply and said, wait a moment for explanation and be gentle. And passing in, carried Maggie to the small chamber on the first floor, laid her on the bed, then stepping back, he shut the door and stood face to face with his vinegar-tempered wife in the passageway out. So, to ignore or to avoid the bad behavior of his wife, he simply said, wait for a moment and be polite. Then he went on the first floor, laid the child on the bed, and when he was coming back, he shut the door. But on his way back to the first ground floor, he met his wife, who was very angry. You haven't brought home that sick brat. Brat means child. Anger and astonishment were in the tone of Mrs. Joe Thompson. Her face was in flame because she was very angry. She understood that he had brought a sick child, that is Maggie. And this was the second question he asked. I think women's hearts are sometimes very hard, said Joe. Usually Joe Thompson got out of his wife's way. It means usually whenever his wife is angry, he simply ignored her. He never argued with her or kept rigidly silent and non-combative when she fired upon any subject. When she got angry on any subject, he remained silent. He ignored her. He never argued with her. It was with some surprise, therefore, that she now encountered a firmly set acquaintance and resolute pair of eyes. So when this time she got angry and he replied with the statement that he thinks that woman's heart is very hard. Woman's heart does not have feelings for anyone. So when she heard this reply, there was a surprise. There was a confusing expression on her face and in her eyes. Women's are not half so hard as men is. So she replied that even men's heart are more hard than the woman's heart. Women's hearts are half hard as compared to the men's heart. Joe saw by quick intuition, said his resolute bearing had impressed his wife, and he answered quickly. So intuition means he understood that his reply has impressed his wife. So now he again answered him. Indeed, it means he again answered him, argued with him, that as it may, every woman at the funeral turned her eyes steadily from the sick child face. When the cart went off with her dead mother, hurried away and left her alone in that moonlight with the sun not an hour in the sky. So he again replied her dad. He said this sentence that women's hearts are very hard because when her mother died, no woman was ready to take care of her. Everybody left her in that hut, and there was only 1 hour was left to set the sun. Where were John and Kane? Asked Mrs. Thompson. Farmer John tossed John into his wagon and drove off. Katy went home with Mrs. Ellis, but nobody wanted the poor sick one. Send her to poor house was the cry. Was the cry means everybody in the crowd said that this child should be sent to poor house. Why didn't you let her go then? Why did you bring her here? So that was another question by Mrs. Joe Thompson, that why did you bring that child to her house? She can't walk to the poor house. Somebody arms must carry her, and mine are strong enough for that task. So he replied that he cannot go herself to the poor house. Somebody has to take, and he is ready for that task. Then why didn't you keep on? Keep on means why didn't you directly go to poor house? Why did you stop here? Demanded the wife. Because I am not apt to go on fool's errand. The guardians must first be seen and permit obtained. Joe Thompson replied that I do not want to look fool in the poor house because first I need to see the guardian, then I need to get the permit, then only I can take that child to the poor house. There was no gainsaying this. Gainsaying, there was no argument, there was no confusion in this. When will you see the guardian? Was asked with irascible impatience, means with anger, with irritation. She asked the next question, that when will you see the guardian? Tomorrow. Why put it off till tomorrow? Go at once for the permit and get the whole thing off your bed hands tonight. Then she said, go ask for the permit, guardian, and finish this task till night. Jane, said Wheelwright with an impressive of tone that greatly subdued his wife. This passage is very important. So Joe Thompson, with a very impressive voice, said this statement, I read in the Bible sometimes and find much said about little children. He said that in the Bible I have read these things about the children, how the Savior rebuked the disciples who would not receive them. Them is used for children. So he said that in Bible I have read that Savior, that God rebuke means get angry disciples mean with the people who do not take care of the children, who do not love the children. How he took them up in his arms and blessed them, and how he said that whosoever gave them even a cup of cold water should not go unrewarded. And the people who loved them even gave them a cold of water, that means even gave us some water to the children, they were always be blessed, take care, and give be reward, would be rewarded by the God. This is from Bible, he said. Now it is a small thing for us to keep this poor motherless little one for a single night, to be kind to her for a single night, to make her life comfortable for the single night. And then he added that it is a very small thing for us that for a single night we would take care of this child, we will make her life comfortable only for a single night. The voice of the strong rough man shook and he turned his head so that the moisture in his eyes might not be seen. Mrs. Thompson did not answer, but a soft feeling crept into her heart. So there were tears in the eyes of Mr. Thompson. He turned his back and he could feel that now Mrs. Thompson had also the feeling on her face and in her heart. Look at her kindly, Jane. Speak to her kindly, said Joe. Think of her dead mother, said loneliness, the pain, the sorrow that must be on her or coming life. The softness of his heart gave unwanted equivalence to his lips. Now he advised to his wife that look at her kindly. Think of the dead mother, think of her condition, think of her loneliness, think of her the pain she would feel in the poor house. And the softness and unwanted expression were in the tone of Mr. Joe Thompson. Mrs. Joe Thompson did not reply, but presently turned towards little chamber where her husband had deposited Maggie, and pushing open the door, went quietly in. Now she did not reply, but went into the room silently where Mr. Thompson laid Mejai in the room. Joe did not follow. He saw that her state had changed. Her condition, her thoughts are changed. So he did not reply and felt that it would be best to leave her alone with the child. And he thought that it would be good for them to leave alone.